How can he hit me from there? I get shot again.
Pretty tasty.
Let's try approaching him from the other side now.
That's the snake next to me.
Thank you. Oh, those were birds. That's rad.
Pretty tasty. Thank you.
if he's here and he's not on that radar, I'm gonna never use it again.
This works.
Call yourself a son of the fox. not hurt. He's gonna heal from his next meal. To heal from your meal is the best deal. Talk to my friend downtown. He ain't no clown. We're the best around. Nothing's ever gonna get you down. Bet you he's on the hill. But can I get there without him seeing me? It's not there. Let's eat a rabbit.
Pretty tasty.
Anything from the motion? I bet you that's the rabbit. When he shows up, he's a lot more active than that. I didn't think he'd be there either. I think there will be an interaction here, though. He'll probably see me first. Thank you. It's just a light on the water. Expecting him to be up there. See a lot from the tree. Movement. Where the fuck were you?
Call yourself a
pretty tasty.
Henry? So on the other side of this hill, it was behind me.
Thank you.
looks like a person. Whoa! Yo, we did it first try.
Spirits of the forest, I thank you. The boss would be proud of you.
Tree jail
the
for
time
you.
Has come for a younger generation to rise. I've been wandering for more than a century, and now my journey comes to a close. What a splendid way to end it all. I have no regrets. I can return to the Forum Arla.
Okay, I know exactly where that is. Alright, let's pause for a second. Talk about what a great MGS villain that was. Aside from this annoying battle, I'd give that character and the character design 10 out of 10. Sometimes with Metal Gear but villains, there's a problem of them being too fantastical, like the bee guy, like that's way too much supernatural power. The way that the sniper was legendary, and when he died his ghillie suit changed season, that was perfect. That was like top tier MGS villain shit right there, in my opinion. Change up our flowers. You gotta be kidding me. Oh my god, this game is something else. I think that has no bullets. Let's get that equipped in case we start to get bullets for it. You know, basically all the guns. That to me is a Metal Gear villain done right. Like, you know, the B guy's a cool idea, but like, kind of over the top. Now, that boss fight was not very fun. If there were to be a drawback, it would be that, but the character itself is fucking sick. He's dead until he fights and shit, like, that's rad. And it took Solid Snake with, like, thermal goggles, AP sensor, binoculars, hell of equipment. And this fucking ladder is like the perfect timing and the song going into it. I gotta appreciate in terms of like them building a player's connection with the action hero gradually over time. You know, the beginning of the game's getting slapped around by the boss, losing the mission and shit. Through this ladder, we find the spirit of battle. The heart lies. What is that? What's the Ryu quote? The battle lies in the heart. What is it? The answer lies in the heart of battle? Something like that. Cheers to the end. Oh, I'm hungry.
Pretty tasty. Pretty tasty.
I have some pretty horrible stats about alerting on pretty much every single possible encounter. But I have gotten two of the bosses on my first try blind. So, you know, give me a little bit of props. But strangely enough, like, that's also what makes these games so fucking good, is, like, after that boss fight, I feel so much more connected with this game. Not even in terms of just it being a story thing or being interested. I've grown as a player. Grown as a snake. Okay, maybe not. Yeah. Okay, so let's bust out some of our equipment. I don't even know what the fuck that is. Okay, those are probably guards. No, it's opening wings. It's probably a bird. Let's just use regular vision. Yes. It is a bird. That is not. Now I could snipe. I could sneak up on him, and if we were to do that, we're gonna do it from this side. And see, like, this level design here, right after a battle like that, like, It's like showing you what you've learned. One of my besties, this is like one of his favorite games, and I see where he's coming from with that. I really do. If I had one drawback on it, I think that they added too much flavor. It's a little saucy on the Kill Bill for me. I think MGS was just like the perfect balance of like action references and humor. It breaks my suspension of disbelief a little bit. See what a pimp I am now? That dude didn't even see. He was looking right at me. But yeah, my friend forming a close attachment with this game, I can see where he's coming from with that. It's a sick ass game. Now, it wasn't until like the science lab that Oh, I got bit by a scorpion. That I was able to control the camera. But once the camera was more manageable, it was a blast. Again, I don't really know what I'm able to get away with and what I'm not. See, like, now this kind of thing is useful. It was only a pain in the ass before. And I started to learn that in the Ocelot fight, because you can dodge a lot of his shots even if he knows where you are. And I'm still not at the point where every time that happens it's intentional. Let's hide from the helicopter and call our friends.
Sigint, the chopper we were talking about is flying around.
The one at the heliport?
Yeah.
Perhaps it's an armed variation of the MI-8 HIP.
No. Some of it looks the same, but the overall shape is different. It's got stub wings and the cockpit canopy looks like an angular greenhouse.
No kidding. Then it must be some kind of new model. I've heard stories recently that the Soviets are developing a flying infantry combat vehicle. That's gotta be it.
A flying infantry combat vehicle?
Yeah, a transport chopper with troop carrying capabilities. Think of it as an attack transport chopper version of France's AMX VCI or the Soviet BMP. They must be doing field tests on the initial prototype.
A next generation chopper that's a little smaller than the HIP. Maybe we should call it a Hind.
Not bad. It's cool with me.
Then it's settled. We'll refer to that new type helicopter as a Hind from now on.
Wow. So the Hind is a real... It's a gunship. I believe. A Soviet gunship. Often referred to as like the counterpart to the Apache, which came way later. It's like the American as the Apache Hind is the Soviet. I'm pretty sure it's much older. It might be even more comparable to a Huey. But the fact that Snake comes up with its nickname during battle, and like that's how I even came to know of it, through the passing on of terminology and me coming up with that information from knowing Call of Duty, another game inspired by action warfare combat, and I don't know, I probably know about the Hind too, just from being a bit of a arms nerd, but let's roll on.
You want to save?
I want to be saved.
Snake, have you seen Earth versus the Spider?
Nope.
It's about this spider that suddenly mutates into a giant monster. They bring it into the city in a state of hibernation, but it wakes up and starts wrecking the place.
So why did the spider turn huge?
I told you, it suddenly mutated.
Yeah, right.
Snake, it's people like you that take all the fun out of watching movies. Always nitpicking and taking things too seriously. Honestly, why even bother? Look, the important thing isn't that it got big.
Then what is important?
The fact that there's a huge spider destroying the city. Suspend your disbelief.
See, I was just talking about this. Damn. Damn.
You made it to the mountains. Those mountains are known as Krasnogorye. The name means the Red Mountain Ridge in Russian. The entire range has been fortified to act as a defense for the great fortress of Groznygrad. The area near the top has been dug with bunkers and trenches, and there are anti-aircraft gun emplacements everywhere. It's literally an impenetrable wall. Proceed with caution. Oh. There's a provision storehouse in the hillside area, and there's an armory at the summit. I'll meet you in the ruins at the top of the mountains. The summit is still a ways up. Keep climbing.
All right. No advice really about this helicopter.
Snake, the altitude in those mountains is pretty high. That means the oxygen concentration in the air is lower than normal.
Man.
When there's less oxygen in the air, naturally you'll be breathing less oxygen as well. And the oxygen content of your blood will go down. In other words, you run the risk of becoming hypoxic. Hypoxia is a very serious condition. In the worst cases, it can lead to pulmonary and cerebral edema. I don't think you need to worry right now, but all the same, be careful.
So, what do I need to be careful about?
In high altitude areas, you will tire quicker than normal.
Okay.
Snake, climbing uphill takes a lot of stamina as it is, but on top of that, the air up there is thinner than normal. You're burning through stamina a lot faster now than ever before. Keep an eye on your stamina gauge. Be sure to eat something to restore your stamina before you run out.
Man, this game.
You found your way to the mountains, I see. There's an underground tunnel near the top. You can use it to sneak into Groznygrad. But Eva said the door to the tunnel is sealed off.
Yeah, she's supposed to bring me the key.
First, rendezvous with Eva and get the key from her. The rendezvous point is in the ruins at the summit. The summit is just up ahead. Proceed to the ruins at the top of the mountain. Eva should be waiting for you there.
Okay, so let's take a second and just address how fucking crazy that was. I was talking about that level design and appreciating it, going into my friend talking about he loving this game so much, me not being so heavy on it because it's kind of Quentin Tarantino a little bit heavy, but still enjoying it. I like it a lot. And then we go and have some conversation with our save person, and they talk about the same exact thing about, you know, you enjoy the movie, don't let your suspension of disbelief, like, you know, get in the way of you enjoying the experience, I guess. I don't know exactly what the takeaway was. I was just blown away with how quickly that conversation happened after I brought it up. And this little alleyway to, like, call people. This game is so good because, like, that was... It invites the player to do things like I just did. It wasn't mandatory at all to call anybody. I did that because it was a good time. Found out about the terrain. Found out about a new mechanic. It's a fucking good-ass game. But also good in the way that a lot of times, like, how art can be good. Where... it doesn't force you to kill this snake. In fact, I'm almost kind of compelled to keep it alive. It's poetic. But the way that the person experiencing it can express whatever freedom they choose and still have a great time. Like, fucking A. Now I might have to kill it if it's being threatening. Bad snake. I think the real turning point of this game getting really good wasn't even just the camera angle thing. That was a big quality of life improvement. It was the drunk Russian dude. And how he was so willing to give up his secrets because he had an ear to vent his career frustrations to. Like, once it started to go there, like, it was like the DARPA chief in the first one. The game... Well, and that's also different about MGS1. MGS1 is, like, from start to finish, fucking kick-ass. This takes a little bit to pick up, but once you get into that third gear, it's one of my favorite games at this point. But just, that's a tricky thing about Metal Gear. Is that, even though it's one of my favorites, I think I like another Metal Gear even more than this. It's like, what's your favorite? I don't even know where this... Oh, maybe I can use my sonar? See, even this, it's coached me into thinking that there's a very rational and soldier-esque way to handle this situation, and there is. And I'm surprised they were able to do this so successfully on the PS2. Which really speaks, like, it doesn't matter how new a fucking game is. I'm gonna try to handle this guy silently. Okay, so they said to keep climbing up the mountain. I might have to interrogate somebody. See? Just that, too. Now I'm thinking that if I don't know where to go, I've gotta put a knife to somebody's throat. This game is fucking good. Okay, but I think I'm going in the wrong direction. Unless there's like a hole in the wall over there. But like these little ridges in this terrain is so intentional. It's like now when you can get us. Oh my god, this game. Okay, so I got that last time. Maybe that's where I got bit by the scorpion. I already got something there. Somebody's gonna see me because I didn't think about that. Did I miss something in the tunnel? I don't think so. Okay, so this is the furthest we've been. Oh, they must have seen the body.
Being attacked. Enemy position unknown. Going into high alert. Acknowledged. Sending reinforcements. Use extra caution.
Someone's walking around. I will say, it was a risk for them to take, 10 episodes for it to really pick up like this. I was like half hooked. Like one or two episodes into this, I was like, okay, I'm committed to see this through. But like at this point, is that what I do? Is the game that good where you come out of the tunnel and you can see what it is that you missed? Bro. You gotta be kidding me. How come I didn't notice this before? Okay, I'm gonna avoid that turret, but I'm taking mental note in case I get into some shit with these helicopters, which are where. And that's also so dope, like, I already know that from, like, kind of, like, gaming kind of conventions. But let's say this was my first time. Oh, see, now I know. Only problem is my gunplay isn't that great. Oh, I forgot. I got in trouble. Else. Okay, well, I gotta call it here, folks. Thank you so much for watching. This game is great.